round Saransh.
So, last session of the day, guys. Are you all excited?
Yes.
No, is it?
Yes.
Like good one. Morning batch?
Yes.
Okay, so then a little more louder.
Good.
I would just raise your energy.
Let's stand in one place.
Yeah. I would just like to, you know, raise our energy levels by just giving a huge round of applause for everybody who was here till the last session.
Very nice job.
Thank you.
Little bit speed, pace needs to be little slow.
Start with encouragement.
No,
then
so sorry.
No, don't be sorry. Sorry,
quite enthusiastic. Little bit improve the pace. I mean, slow it down.
So I'll be just giving you a little bit of background about this session that I'm going to conduct. Okay. So this is basically for some seasoned professionals who are already working into the IT industry. We are to implement a methodology in the industry, in the software development, which is known as BDD. That stands for behavior-driven development. So it's about how the software should be developed in the industry. Okay. So this is a group of professionals with around minimum 3 years and maximum 18 years of experience, 18 to 20 years of experience. There are coaches, there are scrum masters, there are product owners, there are junior and senior engineers as well, who are already into all this. But our job will be, you know, to implant the knowledge in them. Why are we doing it and how do we do it correctly? They already know that they are doing the right thing, but we want to tell you how to do it right. Okay, so that's about it.
Good. Yeah.
So to begin with, I'll tell you all a story. Okay. Once upon a time, what happened? You know, it was raining heavily. I reached back home from my office. Okay, and I was feeling very hungry, very hungry. So what I planned was, you know, it was a really rainy day. I went to a nearby restaurant. I stopped my car. I called the waiter. And I tried to order for something. I told him, hey, bhaiya, just before that, I'd like to ask everybody, like, are you comfortable in Hindi?
Yes. Yeah.
Cool.
Sounds good.
So then I ordered pav bhaji. Okay, I said, bhaiya, mujhko ek pav bhaji lekar aao. Aur usme lassan nahi hone ko chahiye. He said, okay, sir. Okay, so he went back, and I was noticing other people having pav bhaji, having samosas in that beautiful rainy season. Okay. Then, you know, that guy came. He was coming slowly, slowly and slowly. I was watching the pav bhaji. Rather than watching him, I was watching the pav bhaji. How the, you know, fumes were coming out of it. And as he approached me, guess what? I took up the pav bhaji plate inside my car. I was just about to smell something. And guess what? Usme lassan nahi tha. Right. Okay.
I have to say this, that your verbosity has decreased.
And
you're not talking too
much. There is too much suspense occurring in
the story. It's a good thing.
Sorry.
Let
yeah.
it be. Because abhi ek minute nahi hua hai story ka bhi. Another thing is that jo aap bolte ho verbal diarrhea, wo mujhe nahi lag raha hai. I don't know about how you feel, but I don't think it is.
That's a major story.
Which is amazing.
Number of times.
Oh, that is why. Continue. Don't reveal those tricks of the trade.
So, you know, I like the pav bhaji very much, and I was like, you know, it's like Hindi mein bhi se sher ke mukh khun lag gaya. I was actually craving for something more. Then again, you know, as the waiter came to took away my plate, I asked him, bhaiya, mujhko ek chhole bhature ek plate lekar aao. You know, and again he went, and I was like waiting more eagerly than I was waiting for my pav bhaji this time, because I already had something in my stomach, so I wanted to, you know, continue waiting. Then suddenly, you know, this time it was a little faster, that guy came, you know, and he brought me the plate, you know, and I was taking the plate inside, and guess what, I was trying to smell it. Usme lassan tha, exactly, you know. So I think that brings me to the agenda. Why do we need BDD?
Wow.
Did you get something out of it? Like, now come out of the pav bhaji, forget all the chhola bhaturas, like think from the engineers.
Good.
Engineer's hat that you're working in. So let's assume that the pav bhaji or chhola bhatura were the actual software, or the driver or me was the client. But actually, at the end, I was like devastated. I could have said to the waiter that, you know, I don't eat garlic, so it shouldn't have garlic. But it all went wrong. You know, he couldn't make me happy. At the end, I didn't give him a tip.
Very good example.
So can you tell me, like Rajesh? Where did it all go wrong?
So why Rajesh suddenly, bichara?
He was sitting in a relaxed position.
He is just Getting into the group.
Right? So maybe instead of taking the name, you can just say, what do you think?
So anybody, what do you think? What went wrong over there?
Good.
Maybe the expectation.
Expectation, yes. But how do we set the expectation? Anybody from this side? How do we set the expectation?
Setting the requirements.
Exactly. Thank you. Thank you, Rajesh. So, it's basically the requirements that actually go wrong. So, according to a recent study provided by ISTEB, the International Software Testing and Quality Board, 95% of the defects actually happen due to the mismatch in requirements, not actually because of the malfunction of the application.
Wow.
Okay. So, we have to get the requirements right. Now, but how do we do it, right? Everybody, I believe, knows the traditional model of how software development works. There are a few clients, right? And like there are some client-facing people and there are some business analysts in our organizations.
Slow down your pace. Don't rush.
We take the requirements. The PA takes the requirements. They create the requirement documents for us. They give them to the developers, right? The developers build the application. And now, again, from the application or from the business requirement document of the BAs, QAs create their own test cases. Ultimately, our test cases pass 100%. It's like everything is passing. The application is superb. It is QA signed off. But when we go to the UAD, the client kicks it off. They say, this is not what I wanted actually. So where do you think we went wrong? It was about the requirements being caught.
Good use of visualization. Actually, when you said kick it off, you
One moment. You asked a question. Pause. Why in a hurry? We have time. Now you tell him what you need to tell him.
Okay. You are actually using good visualization within the window, and in fact when you said client kicked it, you actually did it, which is good.
Good.
The requirements were not set right.
Exactly. Thank you. So again, everything falls back to the requirements. Now, this brings us to how do we do it? Because we have been doing it for ages now, right? But the most probable question is how? Is it because only we are using BDD only because it is being enforced by our organization? No. Okay. So my idea would be, you know, to let everybody know that, you know, why do we use BDD? Because once we know the power of it, why should we actually use it? We will have more better ideas for all kinds of role and all kinds of people sitting out here, right? But yes, somebody could be a product owner, somebody could be a Scrum Master, somebody could be a Scrum Developer. Everybody has their own specific roles in BDD that we'll look for.
Nasir? Sorry, continue.
So, till here with me, everybody?
Yeah.
Okay. So I think we had a fair idea of why things go wrong. Now we're going to see how do we actually do it. Okay. So to actually do this, I'll plan a activity, okay, to understand how do we actually correct what's been going wrong. So to do this, I would request anybody from that table to come here.
The setup of activity, the why part is still not clear.
To understand how do we correct all that we've been doing wrong. To understand that.
Doing wrong what?
The behavior, the determined development.
Yeah.
So say that one more time.
Alright. So to understand in a little more detail, like what needs to be done in order to be, you know, the false practices that we are being followed and to take the corrective actions for our development, we have a small activity. May I request anybody from that table to just shift it here because I need at least two people here.
Very nice.
Thank you, Sonu. Thank you. So now, listen to the instructions carefully.
No.
This is the client, or I would say this team is the client. You know, and these are the vendors, okay? So Rajesh and Nisar are the vendors, and Abhinav and Sonam are the client. Now, you have to give some requirements to them. They are your vendors who would actually develop the application, right? Got it? Now, you will get exactly 1 minute to jot down your requirements, or I would say I will shorten it down to 30 seconds, okay? You will jot down your requirements. Don't start now. Don't start. Yeah. You get your time.
Go ahead.
Good. Good.
So you will get 30 seconds to jot down your requirements, okay? And they will again get 1 minute to actually written down what needs to be done, okay? You got it?
Yes.
Any questions, anybody, in the instructions?
Good.
Okay. So now here's the boomer, here's the requirement. you need to tell them how to prepare a Maggi.
How to prepare
Maggi. Yeah. Remember, you are declined, you don't have, you know, too much of time to engage with them or anything. You just need to write an email, but just for the sake of facilitation right now, you're just writing it on a piece of paper. Expect it as a soft meal.
Good.
So your time starts now.
How to make a Maggi?
How to make a Maggi? They'll give you the requirements, don't worry about it.
Now probably you may need to go to their desk just to just go and
that's what I want to demonstrate.
One thing that we can do is sometimes when we're giving a task and we want to monitor.
5 seconds more.
So pause. Sometimes when we're giving people a task and if we want to check if people are following it right, go to them and see exactly what he's saying. If they have a doubt, are they doing it okay? That will also help them have that comfort that in case I'm stuck, I can ask you.
No, that's what actually I wanted to demonstrate.
Oh, great. Then it's fine.
I wanted to make the comments unattended.
Okay.
Perfect.
Okay. Do you need more time?
No,
we're done.
Thank you.
Don't be in a hurry. You have all the time. Saransh.
So here we have the requirements. Okay. So now, team B, Rajesh and Nisar, we have the requirements from the client. Okay. You have to develop an application for them according to these requirements. Now, it's all up to you. How do you manage? Do you make some documents? Or, you know, do you directly start coding an application? Or you think backwards, or what do you do?
Too many questions, ask one question at a time.
So, all open to you. The way you want to develop your application, the ultimate goal is to deliver the application to the client to make them happy, right? So, you'll have 1 minute. Whatever strategy you guys have, you can just write it down over here. Okay, then probably we'll have a look. Let me know when you want to start. And the time to gather the requirements, to analyze the requirements will be included in this 1 minute, okay? So shall I start now?
Yes.
Okay. So your time starts now. Meanwhile, the client team, you can decide on what are you actually expecting from a product, okay?
Good. You kept the other team as well busy right
now. Ultimately, the product's gonna come to you. You know, what you can have a kind of a checklist. That's what all I want. So from the strategy, you can
good.
See, you got that?
Good, that's what we want you doing. Good job.
Continue. Good work, the vendor team. But carry on, you're always short on time. Okay.
This is a Maggi.
Excellent. I actually wanted you to write how you do it. That's what I wanted. How will you actually do it? These are the requirements. Forget about the requirement. What it is. Okay. Now, you want to, based on these things, you have to develop a product. How do you do it? Give me a name. Whatever it is, let's assume it is a software product. Yeah, but how do we do it? This strategy. You have to give them the requirement. Let's say that's the use case. There will be many reports inside.
Okay, good. You know when to crackle, you know when to increase the energy, you know when to sell. That is what you need. Got it? I'm glad that you're doing this.
Shantanu, how much time do I have?
You have exactly about 6 minutes left. No, actually, 6 minutes. Why are you rushing them?
The client wants the delivery.
No, don't rush your participants. If you've given them time, let them take that time.
It's already
slow
over.
Slow down.
It's already over. That's the
so indicate it. So we've already run out of time. Last 1 more minute. Yes. So give them that indication.
Okay. So
So team B, last 30 seconds, the client wants the delivery within the next 30 seconds. See, they are already looking at the bills. We're done?
Yeah.
Thank you.
उसको जल्दी है
salaries and the invoices for the product. But believe you me, no one is getting in it.
Yeah.
You have not got your Maggie, yeah. And guys, you've not done a very great job. The client is not very happy with it. Okay? So let me fulfill the gaps out here. Yep. So
that's
the requirement, the first requirement said boil water. Okay? So you switched on the stove and you boiled the water. But I see that it is tapped.
What is mineral water?
Did you give a thought to it? What kind of water is required? Right. Second, the client wanted that you put the masala in next. Okay. So as you put in the boil the water, you put in the Maggi. That's where you made the blunder. That's where you made.
That the is blunder. The power of debrief.
Right. So that's where to go wrong. I am not gonna, you know, complete the activity till the end or the analysis till the end, because would now this bug or this malfunction in the application would actually multiply. Okay, so
final 3 minutes.
So what we need to do is we need to catch all the bugs, all the malfunctions in the requirements itself, right? When we are unsure, we need to capture the behavior of the client. So that's why we say behavior driven development. It's not about assumption driven development. Keep aside the assumptions. Okay. Highlight the risks. When you say water, just mention that we are making it in tap water. If you're not getting any feedback from the client for that. Okay. So the key is to interact with them more often. Okay. Develop your tests, develop your applications in a way such that it reflects the behavior. Okay, so that's how we actually do it. Got my point?
Yeah.
With me till here?
Yes.
Okay. So if you still have any questions, guys, we're gonna break for lunch very soon. If you guys have any questions, I had this chart with me.
There is on the chair.
So since we all have a very fair idea of what BDD is, why do we do it, and how do we do it, we'll cover the further details and the best practices in the sessions to come. What I want from everybody or some of you is, if you have any doubt, if you have any questions in your mind, you can just show them as seats over here, okay? And towards the end of the session, I'll show you how they actually turn out to be into the fruits.
Wow.
Okay? So you need to sow the seeds, and they'll actually turn out to be fruits at the end of the session.
That is okay. So awesome.
May I request everybody to complete this activity before we, you know, start the next session? You have your time.
Good job.
You can break for lunch. You can come back. You can do it anytime.
That's a good action point. Okay.
So to summarize everything that we did till now, okay, we are back from the break, let's assume. Okay, everything has been done. So do we have a fair idea of what BDD is?
Yeah.
Yes.
Thank you. Nishar, can you explain it a little more what BDD is?
Okay, that's one question. Let's move on with the answer. We'll skip the answer. We want to hear your questions. Okay.
Abhinav, how do we correct the actions? How do we correct software development?
Excellent. Next question.
Anybody who has any questions in mind?
Superb. Now, one thing that he did well was, before we give the handover over here for the coach to give the feedback, the last portion where he spotlighted, that was good. Because he's earned the right after having given the session to hold everyone accountable, and hence we are spotlighting. That's absolutely fine to do because you've already given the entire session. You've given the learning. You've checked their understanding with an activity. So it's not a wrong thing to do when you want to spotlight and make someone accountable for their learning. Good job on that. Okay. Done?
So do we have everything on the same page?
Yes.
Thank you so much everybody for spending your time, and let's stay connected. Let's hope that, you know, we get a chance to walk, to work, or to connect together. Here is my LinkedIn handle where you can connect with me.
Very
and
good.
We can discuss any further technical discussions that we have.
Thank
you so much for your time.
Slow down, what's the hurry? The last part of your connecting part is the most important part. That is where you're leaving your impression and mark. Don't hurry. This is my LinkedIn profile. You can always stay connected. This is where you are creating a need for them to connect with you apart from the session. That was a very smart thing to do, by the way. Fantastic. Let's give him a round of applause. Well done. So let's hear it from the coach. Yes, what's your feedback?
I can say it
So, well done, Saransh. You actually put the good use of that story, correlating it with the business-driven, behavior-driven development.
Sure.
Which had actually make a good use of understanding those things from a layman's term, actually. So, good. You have also good visualization traits. I mean, you use that correct window, and sometimes you goes beyond that window, but only when it is required.
Mm-hmm.
As I said about that kicking action, that was fantastic.
Mm-hmm. Feedback. Keep
you also knows you are very confident in what you are delivering. You know what you are delivering, so you are very confident in that. So absolutely, there is no locking in that.
Mm-hmm.
You also know when to tone down and tone up your pitch. Actually,
yeah,
so that is also
good observation.
Mm-hmm. Now, may I ask you, Saransh, why are you delivering this training? To meet whom's expectations?
Good.
Come again.
Why are you delivering this training? To meet whom's expectations?
Whose expectations are you meeting?
Whose expectations?
To meet the stakeholder as well as the participant expectations.
What happens if you do not meet those expectations?
Okay.
You may not get paid for
that.
Let him
answer that.
Okay.
What will happen if they don't meet the expectations?
That's fine. I think there could be some gap in their understanding, or there could be a gap in our understanding.
So let's say there's a gap because of which your stakeholder expectations don't get met. How will that affect you?
Not affect me big time, because, you know, we already have a commitment of the content that is to be covered.
Fair enough. Let's say they don't perform as per the agreement that the client has with you. Does that affect you?
No, not much. Actually, you know, because the stakeholders actually know about their people. They are their people. So they already know about it, who's going to perform excellent, who's not going to perform.
Which is fine. But since they are hiring you as their knowledge partner,
mm-hmm.
they want that sense of return, right? So as an entrepreneur, do you want to see that ROI, right, for them? So somewhere it can affect you, if not directly, indirectly.
Mm-hmm.
What's your next question?
So the return of investment, and you understand this term, right? So what you need to do is to ensure that they are grasping everything well. You do not lose your revenue or something, future business. You need to ensure that whatever you are delivering, you need to ensure they are grasping it very well.
Mm-hmm.
So there are two suggestions. One thing is that you need to slow down your pace. That is the one thing. Second thing is that when you were delivering the session, you might have seen some people were distracted, like Naseem was checking his mobile. So he was one of the trainee who was not focusing on your session. Mm-hmm. So probably you need to learn some ways where you need to bring those people being into the
good
business.
Observation. Are you getting it? Mm-hmm. So somewhere, why we chose this route for you? See, because you are the only person in this room right now who's wearing multiple hats. You also have to manage your clients. You have to. So there is a lot of pressure. Let's understand that. Plus, you are an expert. So you can make this audience eat out of your hands. Use that. Aap wow karke chhod sakte ho. Aur wo ek hi tarike se ho sakta hai. Agar aap slow down karo, number one, jo hoega, aapko pata hai, aap fast bolte ho, wo ho jayega. Don't beat yourself for it. Aur dusri cheez ye hai, इस ऑडियंस पे ज़्यादा अकाउंटेबिलिटी डालो जिससे वो आपको जितना हो सके आंसर दे. वी आर नॉट सेइंग दिस बेसिस दिस सेशन. वी आर आई सॉ दैट फ्लो बाय द वे यू नो दैट यू रिटन देयर बीडीडी है ना आपका. सो द पॉइंट इज यू हैव द होल डे जितना हो सके प्रैक्टिस में उनको आप अकाउंटेबल बनाओ सो दैट वो आपको ये क्लियरली बता सके दैट आपका जो टॉपिक आप जो आपको ट्रेन कर रहे हो उस पर मुझे क्लैरिटी है. जितना ज़्यादा आप इस ऑडियंस से पार्टिसिपेशन लोगे उतना ज़्यादा आप इम्पैक्ट क्रिएट करोगे.
दैट्स यू नो इन दीज डेज दिस इज द फर्स्ट आई वुड से स्टेटमेंट ऑफ एवरी क्लाइंट वी डोंट वांट थ्योरी वी वांट हैंड्स ऑन सेशन
सी
एंड ऑल माय सेशंस डू नॉट हैव अ पीपीटी इवन
लवली
यू नो सो आई डू नॉट गो विद अ पीपीटी व्हाटएवर आई स्पीक आई राइट इट देन एंड देयर एंड मे बी समटाइम्स आई ट्राई टू यूज सम स्मार्ट टूल्स वेयर यू नो आई कैन राइट इन राइट देन देन एंड देयर व्हिच टर्न्स आउट टू बी लिटिल अट्रैक्टिव लाइक अ पीपीटी.
Yeah. So keep that, you know, keep that thing even more interactive and slow down. That's all. Anything else that you want to add?
Yeah. And that is the appreciation. Actually, I want to say you are the first participant in this entire session who is actually leaving no stone unturned.
Yes.
Because you shared your LinkedIn address,
yes.
Twitter address. So there is a post training support as well.
Yeah.
Which will basically connect the trainees with the trainer in future as well, and you may get good business as well.
That's the strategy that we need to
do. Attire people is there, but program people.
Anybody else want to give the feedback?
Yeah, so Saransh, I want to say he is a perfect gap analyzer because he thinks and observes it very keenly. And off the record, I would like to say that Saransh is a very, very nice coach because he observes.
Tell him in his straight on his eyes.
Saransh, you are a better coach, and whenever you are going to monitor anyone under you, I'm sure he or she going to.
I agree with you. Yeah. I think Saransh, that's a very, very big compliment. Good job on that observation. Anything else?
Yeah. So Saransh, you have been able to connect with all of us using your visual management quite beautifully. So in your presentations to larger audience.
Thank you. Wonderful. So to sum it all up, anything from this table? Okay.
I want to hear something about my facial expressions.
Would you like to share?
I have never, you know, experienced something like that. But yes, I feel, you know, sometimes something is showing on my face.
Do you feel different in your performance today?
Yes, a little.
What is that change?
Because, you know, I was being a little conscious till the first half of the day. I was like, I don't know what to do. I'll go by own self. But yes, in the, you know, when Sonam's presentation started, I just made up my mind that, you know, I'm not going to do anything.
Okay.
As planned.
Okay.
Okay, I'll go with,
go with the flow.
Because I have spent like around 24 hours over here and that will come naturally.
So I have to share this with you that your ability to have fun over there, mm-hmm. you like being on the stage. I hope you know that. Yeah. Your ability to also, you know, engage with people. And the passion with which you do what you do, that is visible. We can see that. You're excited, you're on your toes, you know, literally. And मुझे नहीं लगता आपको कहीं ना कहीं you know gap भी महसूस होगा अगर आप यहाँ से निकल के बाहर अगर lawn में अगर आप session लेते हैं आप वहाँ भी session ले लोगे. That's how engaging you are. As a person also you are like that. So I think that is, it's visible. Would you agree? He's visibly very interactive. Another thing that I also wanted to say is you're a driver. You are determined. कि एक बार आपने ठान लिया कि मुझे करना है तो मैं करके छोड़ूंगा नहीं तो तब तक नहीं छोड़ूंगा. That is an amazing instinct to have. especially not just as an entrepreneur but also as a facilitator. It gives the person the assurance that he's not going to give up on me. And that's why possibly Sonam mentioned that you're a good coach. That's a very big compliment. It's not so easy.
I'm, you know, planning to have a people coach certification.
Oh, wonderful.
So I've been doing
then you're on the right track.
People.
Fabulous.
So that's the practice, you know, that actually comes out.
And you're creative. You have the ability to make smallest of the, you know, technical of the things being relatable with something as, you know, simple as Maggie. I mean, who would have thought? So that brings that sense of creativity out. A lot of analogies that you use in your sessions. You're observant also, very, very, very strong observant eye for detail. Couple of things that I'm not going to talk about your pace. I think we've said enough. We just need you. Understand one thing. You're in an industry where you have almost spent now how much time?
Almost like 5 years into this.
Right.
B2B.
And you clearly are one of the known faces in the industry, right? So one thing that you have to consciously work on is, although you may be training a lot of millennial audience, young audience, they need to look up to you. When I mean by that, I mean when you're there in the room, have a demeanor that is much more patient. Ek wo thehrav aana chahiye. You know, people should look up to you that, my God, he is so inspiring. Wo gravitas aana chahiye. To wo gravitas aap kahan laoge? Ye aapko khud sochna padega. You know, be instructive when you want to instruct. Be a coach when you want to give support. Be friendly, but don't be a friend.
That's what we do.
That is what you have to work on.
People say that, you know, you are being friendly, you brought me here, now you're pushing me
along. Accommodating mat bano itna. Thoda sa apna, hum Delhi mein bolte hai na, chaude mein khade ro.
Chaude
mein. Very inspiring, well done, good job. Very good job.
Chaude mein khade?
So in Delhi,